old school. I'm a 40-something gamer, man. My first system was Pong.
And I'm Rocco. I'm 26, and my first system was Game Boy.
And together, we travel the country, visiting all the arcades, barcades, and fun centers we can to give you accurate views on if you should go there and spend your money.
So come with us on this journey across gaming America.
Continuing season 3 of One Button Joystick, and we are in an all-new state, Ohio. It's round in the front.
Round in the back.
And ha! In the middle. We're at the 16-bit barcade. All right, let's do this. I'm going hard. Now, this is an Empire Strikes Back machine, not a Star Wars machine, even though it's the same exact game and there is no Death Star in Empire Strikes Back. But we're not going to worry about that. It's made by Atari, so it's all love. All love all day long.
Let's just get to the review. It's a place you get what you pay for.
Yeah, which is a drink. Like, at 16-bit arcade, all you have to do is walk in and buy a soda or any alcoholic beverage, and you can play all the games for free. The games are on free play.
Yeah.
Problem is, they're all broke and malfunctioning. I mean, we're talking about literally joysticks that don't work, buttons that stick.
Piss yellow screens, glitchy as hell.
Literally,
yeah.
It's a fun place for a first timer. Anything outside of that, dude, a real gamer would be enraged, and we're enraged. I don't know about you, man, but I say on the barcade scale, dude, that it gets a D minus,
yeah.
Only because it has some games that do work, but we're talking about a very low number out of their entire setup, dude. D minus. Continuing our video game Cleveland arcade journey, we're now at the Super Eclectic Pinball Parlor, dude. Are you ready for some pinball?
Oh, I'm so ready. And to get out of this damn cold.
It's really not that cold, but... It just got stuck?
Looks like it's stuck, bud.
Video games. We're semi-decent at those. Pinball? They do have a multicade. Pandora's Box 5. They got Moonwalker. Moonwalker. This arcade version of Moonwalker is the definitive version with this three-quarter bird's eye view down. I mean, like, the Genesis port was all right with its side-scrolling action, but it never had, like, the feel of this game, because nothing looked like this game at the time when this came out, way back in the early 90s. I was still in high school. Yes, I've dated myself. Dance time. There's one more reason why Sega is a much better system than Nintendo. They had the balls to make a video game of Michael Jackson saving children. Loaded with children. This is Kids for Days. Isn't it just like us to come to a pinball parlor and only sit here playing a main multi-cade video arcade? The one guy in there, he basically told you that you suck at pinball, yes. Dude. This place was different. I don't really know how to sum it up because it was all pinball and they only had one game, but it was fun. I liked it. What do you think?
I mean, I liked it.
It was a little small, but... It's fitting for what it is.
Yeah.
So I think we're going to have to create a new category here of pinball cafe rating.
I guess.
I'm going to give it a B?
Yeah.
B plus?
I'm going to say B plus strictly because of Pandora's Box. Major points there.
Yeah, well, real quick, too. This is one of the things about pinball. It's making its resurgence on the back of the retro video game, classic video game type of movement that we've been having. So... there'll be more of these popping up, I'm sure, or they already exist and we just don't know and haven't been able to hit them yet.
B plus.
And our last stop on the Ohio Video Game Arcade Tour is, I forgot the name already, goddammit, what is it?
Full Blast Arcade and Amusements.
Here in North Ridgeville, Ohio. Scoring me so I can do something better. my game this evening, man? That's heartbreakingly sad. But we're going back in. All right. We're not counting that.
So old school is making me play Popeye because evidently I don't play enough retro games. Oh, this doesn't seem so bad. What am I catching? Oh.
Right, you're catching the hearts. Don't go near. I'm getting
choked. Oh. See, that would have been nice to know, you know, from jump. Okay.
Okay, so you're catching the hearts and you can only get the spinach off the side. When the spinach pops up, that's when you can go hit Bluto. But the object of the game is to capture the hearts.
Oh.
Get the hearts? Stay in Bluto. All right, get that spinach.
Oh, spinach. No, go down. Let me get out. Oh, no. Give me that. Really?
You have to punch it.
Oh.
Punch it. All right, now go hunt down Bluto.
All right. Come here, you... No.
Down the stairs, down the stairs. Get him, get him, get him, get him.
You're about to get jumped on me. Oh, no.
Oh, no. Die Hard Arcade. We're off the bat. This does not look like John McClane. There's nothing about this that in any way screams Die Hard at all. Like, why is he wearing a police jacket?
I mean,
I don't played this before, I thought, but I don't remember it being so non-movie specific. Oh, should I come back from the bathroom when I discover you on Donkey Kong, dude? Have you played this before in life? Have you ever seen this before in life?
I, obviously, yes, and no, I don't think I actually played it myself.
First level on the first try.
Very nice.
Thank you. Wait, what?
What?
No!
And now our short review for the final arcade in Ohio that we visited.
Full blast, arcade and entertainment.
Yes, yes. No, amusements.
Amusements.
Okay. We are trying to be professional reviewers here. Full Blast Arcade and Amusements, a tried and true real video game arcade. Not a barcade, not a fun center, a straight up arcade, man.
And one of the nice things about it is that everything was organized. You had your fighters in one place, your shooters in one place, your drivers in one place, and your classics. That basically took up the main hall.
Yeah, exactly. And they only had a few games that weren't working, but see, this is the problem with some of these places, man. They have good variety, it feels like an arcade. Both of my two favorite games, though, at Full Blast did not work. The spinner on Tron didn't work, and the goddamn left movement on the Dig Dug joystick did not register. But I mean, so it's like, all right, you know, me. But I mean, outside of that, everything else worked great.
It really does feel like a tried and true arcade.
Yes,
like
that's
exactly what it is, and that feeling is
awesome. I mean, so on this one, dude, I'm gonna go, it's either B or C plus. I'm gonna say, based on how many we've been seeing now, the fact that some of the games didn't work and they were my favorite games, I'm gonna go C plus.
I'm gonna go with B. Just a B, not a plus.
Right, so let's split the difference and give it a B minus.
Yeah. I'm good with that.
So that was our trip to Ohio, man. I hope you guys really enjoyed it, dude.
Thank you so much for tuning in, and stay tuned for the rest of Season 3.
Against this one wall, it's like, what is this place called again?